The next Mahavidya that we are dealing with is Dhumavati. The goddess, the Mahavidya, represented as a widow. Now here is a description. While the rest of the Mahavidyas, even when they're ferocious, angry, holding weapons of destruction and so on, are mentioned as beautiful in face and so on, Dhumavati is described differently. Here's a description. Dhumavati is ugly, unsteady and angry. She's tall and wears dirty clothes. Her ears are ugly and rough. She has long teeth and her breasts hang down. She has a long nose. She rides in a chariot that has a banner on top, decorated with a crow emblem. Her eyes are fearsome and her hands tremble. In one hand she holds a winnowing basket. With the other she makes the gesture of conferring boons. Her nature is rude. She is always hungry and thirsty and looks unsatisfied. She likes to create strife and she is always frightful in appearance. What do you do about a goddess like that? Description further says, she has two hands which hold a skull bowl and a spear. Her complexion is black. She wears ornaments made of snake and a dress is made of rags taken from the cremation ground. Another description says that the goddess should be imagined in the following way. Her complexion is like the black clouds that form at the time of cosmic dissolution. Her face is very wrinkled and her nose, eyes and throat resemble a crow's. She carries a broom, a winnowing fan, a torch and a club. Her face has a venomous expression. She is very old and she wears the plain clothes of a mendicant. She has disheveled hair. She is without mercy. She frowns. Now, outside the Mahavidya group, Dhumavati is barely known. But she bears striking similarities to some other goddesses. In particular, Nriti, Jeshta and Alakshmi. All three of these goddesses are inauspicious, dangerous and avoided by people. Nriti is known in the earliest Veda, the Rig Veda, as a dangerous and inauspicious goddess. One hymn mentions her, and its concern is to seek protection from her or to ask that she be driven away. She is equated with death, bad luck and destruction. The hymn sums up Nirthi's nature very well. After four verses asking the gods for renewed life, wealth, etc., youth, continued long life, the following is said, let Nirthi depart to distant places. Which means she is considered the opposite of the blessings that are sought. Now the goddess Jeshta also appears in early Hindu traditions. She enjoyed a widespread cult during some periods. Some of her images may be found in South India, even as early as 7th and 8th centuries. Physically, she resembles Dhumavati. She is described with a flabby belly, thick thighs, raised nose, hanging lower lip, and is in color as ink, sometimes black, sometimes red, holds a lotus and a water pot. She rides a donkey or is drawn in a chariot by lions or tigers. She also carries a broom, like the witches who fly on the broom. According to the Linga Purana, she was born when the gods and demons churned the ocean to obtain the nectar of immortality. She was given in marriage to the sage Dusshera, who soon discovered that his unattractive wife could not bear the sound or sight of any kind of pious activity. When he complained to Vishnu, Vishnu told Dusshera to go with his wife only to places where inauspicious things occur. Hence, Jeshta's popular epithet, Alakshmi, one who is inauspicious. Dhumavati, therefore, is very similar, is perhaps another form of a Lakshmi.